This is The Antidote with Dave Hawkins, where Christian music doesn't suck. I'm Dave Hawkins, and this is The Antidote. We're going to carry on with trip number two of our search into the psychedelic music of Christian artists who recorded their music during the psychedelic era of the late 60s and early 70s. These two episodes, you know, have been really tough to put together. First with trying to find the music and the info about the bands, but I think the hardest part has been choosing which songs should end up on the playlist, because I discovered a lot of music. Well, tonight we let off with Out of Darkness with Thank You, Lord, which sort of comes across as, I guess, like a psych version of the Stones. But a totally different style of psychedelic music comes from the Reverend Nicholas Frond, who headed to San Francisco in 1968 and laid down a single album with some of his students. It's a 9-minute creepy trip of God-soaked mind expansion. So many things from the search party.
Thank you. nobody needs me. I want someone to share the nothing that I have to offer. I want someone to give me, to turn me up for just a little while. Somebody should know what it's all about.
Coming up, the Trees community with the Psych Folk Psalm 46. In 1972, Parchment, their album Light Up This Fire, was released and was said to define British Jesus music. It had a radio hit, a lot of contemporary folk, along with a couple of songs that fit the psychedelic folk style.
Thank you.
of the best-known Christian psych rock bands was Wilson McKinley. Their album Spirit of Elijah came out during the summer of 1971. It was recorded in one overnight session without editing or overdubs, and its moody blues-influenced style really made this album stand out. Caffey with Joy Comes in the Morning. And coming up is a California trio who love their fuzz guitar and Hammond organ, Truth from Harvest Light.
Yeah.
Maybe more blues than true psychedelic, but here's Third Eye from Chicago's The Excursions.
Thank you. Robert, you. I'll tell you what I honestly think. I can still think. All these religious people walking around telling me my soul needs a shower. They say it stinks. Can you imagine that? Well, I remember just how to cleanse my soul from my younger days in parochial school. Oh, wait a minute, I'm much older now. Doing all that religious stuff, it just ain't cool. Is it? Never lied. Never lied to me. It said you gotta get yourself together with the Lord just as soon as you can. Yeah. Well, who knows, man? Maybe in the presence of the Lord, maybe that'll make me a whole man.
Teenage Jesus Freak Jam Band, Rainbow Promise, with Get Ready.
Oh, you may think by being a good man, or you may think by playing a Christian, you may think that God will spare you just because of the love he has for you. But Jesus knows what's in your heart. He has been here from the start. He knows who really loves him. The ones who don't dare to abandon, get ready, for my Lord is coming back.
Think that New York's Tamalpais Exchange took a few cues from the Mamas and the Papas on their 1970 self-titled Atlantic Records release, but the song Blainsmore Lane really broke away from their typical sound with its softer style.
Lately when I listen to the
Harp introduced the guitar virtuoso Phil Keaggy to the world, and he's still out there recording and performing. In 1971, the band released their second Decca release, the outstanding Synergy LP, which included this great track, Never Is a Long Time.
Down by the docks, I'm never gonna hold me down, boy.
Our next artist includes some modern church history. Vatican II found the Catholic Church wanting to modernize its outlook. And what came about was a young priest and songwriter, André Dumont, taking over as artistic director for RM Discs, which was based out of a church in Cap-de-la-Madeleine. He looked towards creating some new styles of rhythmic masses, led by some of the folk artists found in Quebec. In 1970, Dumont pushed his concept of a pop liturgy through his band Agape. What came out was a simply amazing album, Les Troisième Seaux.
Thank you.
Eden from Agape. And it's just about the end of the Antidote's feature on early psychedelic music from Christian artists. You know, if you like what you've heard, you're probably going to find finding this music difficult to see online. But you know what? It's worth the trouble. And as usual on the Antidote, I'm switching the style of music completely around on our next episode. I had a really interesting talk with singer-songwriter Tyson Motzenbacher of San Diego, and he shares about the struggle he's had dealing with the grief over his mother's death, and that tone is encapsulated on his new release, Letters to Lost Loves. Our chat and his music is coming up next week. And I'm not quite done with the music of Quebec's Agape. I totally adore one of the songs in particular, and I hope you go for this too. La fin du temps. See you next week.
Love.